Prison is legal in a society of life. Prison is legal because it's a state where people who violated a written law, a constitution of the land, are kept. And the prison is so good because it helps to reduce criminals in the streets. Prison helps so that people can be a danger, that will be dangerous to life in society, are being kept. So for that reason, God allowed prisons. God encouraged prisons to be. And then the institution of the land also permits prisons to be. Now, like a country like UK, we have over 50 prisons in this country. Although governments are making every effort, they are doing their best to close down prison with the anticipation that crime will reduce in the society. And that is why government will prefer to reduce crime so that prisons can be decongested. Government spent a lot, millions of pounds in order to sustain life, because people go to prison because people have rights to life. For the fact that people still have rights to life, they become dangerous to life in society. Then for that reason, government build prisons in order to keep people away from from other people in society from being armed. Now, when we look at a society like this, number one, CSC are not doing enough, or let me say we are doing nothing about prison evangelism. But inspiration will start coming in gradually. First of all, when CSC was established in this land, we focused on the church ministries alone. The other aspects of investing to the society were left out completely. But thank God that we have one of our father who is seated here today. Through him, through his personal choice, through his personal idea, he makes us to understand that there are more that we can do. Not about just preaching, not about just managing church, not about just fellowshipping together, but in what way can we as a church invest and contribute to the growth of the society? Now, well, I don't know much about how he started the journey, but today we thank God that he is a qualified, a certified chaplain in this country today. Now, through him, a lot of people, including myself, were encouraged to understand that to be an evangelist, to be a preacher, to be a man of God, is not when you are retired to the four walls of the assemblies. There are much more that we can do to make life better for people out there. And then through him, we have a fellowship with an organization called Free Church Groups. Through that, then we are getting to know much about how we can get involved in the hospital care, in the education system in this country, in the prison system in this country, even in the most of the football clubs, they have chaplain. And through that, there are many jobs that people don't see, that even to meet their ethnic, their daily bread, to be a salary earner, to at least to have a source of incomes. There are many ways for us to live comfortably and also to be a blessing to people who are dying. And through that, for example, myself, about a few years ago, I was encouraged. I do a few courses about chaplaincy and something like in the hospitals. But today, probably a few weeks ago, I just got a letter from the Free Church that I should be appointed, nominated as a member of the standing committee within of the Free Churches group that will manage, look at the progress of the prison in this country. Now, while I was in the meeting yesterday, I discovered that we African churches, we are not winning souls. What we pursue is titles. We can do everything. If, like, permit me to use this way, you are ignorant when you say that white, they are not soul winners. It's because you are the target to your community, black. That's when we thought that they forsaken Christianity. I joined people to say that, oh, White people, they brought Christianity to us in Africa. We are the one evangelizing them. We are not evangelizing them. If we are evangelizing them, how many white people do we have in our church today? If we are evangelizing them, how many multicultural do we have in our church today? We are not evangelizing them. They have their own way of doing their evangelism without making noise. Mm. What we do is to go and spend millions to hire Excel, to hire Emmanuel Center, to do posters, billboards, to announce a great evangelist, a renowned preacher, a renowned man of God is coming to town. And then we gather people and then we encourage them. We put rope on the neck of people to raise funds.
Mm.
And that's the kind of evangelism we do. Yesterday, my eyes were open. I have a privilege to know that when it comes to, if Christ comes today, beloved, and we have a lot of cases, a lot of answers, questions that we have to answer.
Hmm.
When it comes to evangelism, we are zero. The people I met, they were white. But listen to me, when they began to share experience, they ask me questions about what are we doing about prison. I said, we are not doing anything, but thank God I'm here. We are starting.
Oluwashim.
Amen.
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 These are the people, one of them told me that he himself is a reverend of Anglican Church, Assemblies of God Church, but he spent at least twice in a week going to the prison. Bob was telling us yesterday how he do baptism for about probably 50 prisoners. Mm. And he was giving his report this year.
Mm.
50 prisoners through him have given their life to Christ. They were baptized into the body of Christ.
Mm.
Whereas, what we were doing, we do shakara, we embarrass God at times.
Mm.
When we want to say that we want to do evangelism, we embarrass God. God will look at us at times, he will be thinking that what these people are doing.
Hmm.
But there are people, silently, they are winning souls.
Hallelujah.
They are making wasted destiny to be regenerated.
Hmm.
They are making people who have no hopes anymore. I was trying to understand that now, in the next 20 years to come, the number of black prisoners will outnumber the number of white prisoners in this country. Then, while they were coming to this country, many of them, they were coming with anticipation to go and look for success. Oh, I want to go to abroad. I want to go and make it. I want to go to abroad to go and study. But many people have come here with one reason or the other. Their life has been mismanaged.
Hmm.
And the guy was telling us that they don't understand us. When we speak to them about Christ, they don't understand it. That if they can get people who have their understanding, their way of life, they are winning souls. They are doing baptism for prisoners.
Hmm.
And they will come out of the prisons and they become preachers of the gospel.
Hallelujah.
Now we will sit down there. We will sit down there and we condemn people. Whereas we don't know that the people we are condemning, they are the one that God is praising. They are the one making God's apple in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Look at what we've turned our churches to today. What we call evangelism is, I am a pastor under your ministry, and I will be speaking to two people, three people, in order how I will move them away to start my own church
ministry.
And then when we say that, and then when we talk about church grow simply means, oh, this place cannot contain us. Let's go to another street where there's no church. Let's speak to people around here. Let's convert people around who have never been a member of the local, who have no place to worship. But today, if you know people around, you speak to them how to make them your member of the church. Whereas we are building church of which that doesn't have soul winning. Hmm. Now, when we look at the statistics, you can go and Google prison life in UK. You can go and Google the list of prisons in UK. You will see the numbers of prisons. You will see the situations of the prisoners. And you will see the way the number of prisoners is being increased every day in a year. Government are building more prisons because people are committing crimes, and I said it, people committed crimes of which if they are well managed, they wouldn't have committed that crime. A lot of people committed a crime, I said, because they were mismanaged. No good mentor. Somebody was telling me a story. He was an ex-convict. I met him in this country. He told me how he went to prison because his pastor introduced him to 419.
Hmm.
His pastor use his name, use his detail, everything, his house address. They will buy goods, they will fly through first class airline, and in the